Good morning, students. How are you enjoying this season? I hope you are taking proper care of yourself and maintaining social distancing. Please take good care of yourself. Stay home and stay safe. Myself, Mrs. Shagufta Sheikh, the class teacher of Standard 4D Tulsi, will be teaching you EVS 1. Students, you are aware that all living things have three basic needs. They are food, water, and air. Students, our today's topic also relates to the same. Our topic is the interrelationship between living things. Students, I have one riddle for you to solve. Let us read together. An age-old tree with a thick, strong trunk gives deep, dark shade from the scorching sun. Like an old man's beard with many strands, it has ropes for swinging from every branch. Have you guessed it? Yes, it's right. It's a banyan tree. Students, can you tell me if you have seen these plants in your surroundings? Plants are useful to us in different ways. The images of some plants are shown to you. Can you recognize them? Our first image is of betel vine plant. The second plant is of palus. The third image is of fenugreek plant, which is also called as methi. The fourth image is of vasaka, which is also called as adulsa. And the last image is of curry leaf plant, which is also called as karipatta. Students, you all will agree that we have basic needs such as food, water and air, clothes and shelter. All these needs are fulfilled by the environment, but there are differences in the needs of each kind of living things. Now you have to try this at your home. There is one experiment for you. Take two small boxes, label them box 1 and box 2. Fill them 3/4 with soil. Make the soil moist enough to sow seeds. Sow two sprouted moth, that is mutki seeds, in each box. Give 2 spoons of water to the soil in box 1, only once every day. Give 4 spoons of water to the other box 4 times a day. Do this for 6. Here we have taken 2 pot. For the first pot, we have labeled it as A, and for the second pot, we have labeled it as B. We have filled the pot with 3/4 of soil, and the soil is moist enough to sow the seed. So, 2 sprouts of moth, that is mutki seeds, in each box. Give 2 spoons of water to pot A in once a day, and 4 spoons of water to pot B 4 times a day. This you have to do for 6 days. Do this for 6 days. What will you see? The plant in box 1 are growing well, but the plant in box 2 have begun to rot. What does this tell us? Plants that are not aquatic plant cannot grow in marshy areas. If they get more water than they need, they rot. Students, now we will learn. Any type of living things will be found only where all its needs are fulfilled. Let us see this through an example of a tiger. A tiger has stripes. A tiger lies in wait for its prey among all tall grasses. Its prey cannot see it in the grass because of its stripes. There are animals like deer, the nilgai, and the bison in the grassland. When the tiger is hungry, it can feed on them. For a tiger, that also needs to be a water hole nearby, which never dries up even in summer. There must also be dense vegetation, tall grasses and caves in hills or mountains in the areas so that the tiger can find shelter. A tiger inhabits an area where all these things are available. Students, animals are our best friend, isn't it? Now we will see of animals. We keep animals in order to satisfy our needs. They become dear to us. We look after them. When they fall ill, we take to a vet. These animals too return our affection. We get milk, meat, eggs, and several other things from animals. Animals are useful to us for carrying burdens, for drawing carts. Domestic animals also help with heavy farm work in fields. Dogs guards our house, sheep gives us wool. Here are the images of animals, how they help us. Next we'll see. Just as we need animals, we need plants too. Plant gives us food grains, vegetables and fruits. We love flowers too. We use them for many different purposes. We get flowers from plant. We also get cotton wool from plants to make cotton clothes. We grow plants that are useful to us methodically. We sow seeds. We make sure that they get water. We give manure whenever necessary. We spray pesticides if they are attacked by insects. Plants too give us abundantly. They satisfy our needs. Here are some images. First we can see how we sow the seeds. The next is how we water the plant every day. And the picture below is of how we spray pesticides to prevent them from the insects. Students, here is the new term for you to learn. That is arboreal. This word comes from the Latin word arbor, which means tree. Arboreal means living in trees. Animals like monkeys and squirrels live on trees. It gives them certain advantages. Being at a height, they are better able to defend themselves from their enemies. Besides, they can eat the fruit of the trees to satisfy their hunger. Such animals are said to be arboreal. Unknowingly, they help the tree with who support the life. As they move around here and there in surroundings, they spread the seeds of the fruit they have eaten through their dropping. Because of this, new trees grow in different places. Some types of birds too find trees useful for building the nest. Can you see the pictures? They are arboreal animals. Students, now we'll see seasonal changes in living things. We have three seasons, summer, the rainy and the winter. It is very hot in summer. We wear cotton clothes and drink plenty of water. In the rainy season, we use umbrellas or different kinds of raincoats and hoods to avoid getting wet in the rain. In winter, we wear woolen and other warm clothes to protect ourselves from the cold. Here are the images of our three seasons, that is summer season, rainy season and winter season. Just as the three seasons affect us, they affect all other living things too. We see these changes taking place in the living world every year, year after year. Winter in Maharashtra is also called the season of Pangal, that is the falling of leaves. That is because many trees shed their leaves in winter. The coat of many furry animals become thicker in winter. This keeps them warm in the cold seasons. Such growth of hair is especially noticeable in animals.